And Aussie soccer legend and activist Craig Foster has been crowned Father of the Year. He's been recognised for his mentoring and coaching efforts with young people, in particular Afghan migrants. Craig has a son and two daughters of his own, and they couldn't be more proud.
For everything that he's done for the community, and he's obviously such a giver and supports women and children. So not only he's an amazing dad to us, and you know, we get the real Craig Foster, but everyone gets, you know, this amazing giving Craig Foster in the world.
And speaking of the amazing Craig Foster, please welcome him.
Wow, gee.
Congratulations.
My daughters, how beautiful they are.
I know.
Just
well,
incredible.
Teenagers are meant to find dads really annoying and embarrassing. I mean, it must be so lovely to hear them say that.
Yeah, it's lovely. I mean, they're really amazing kids. Of course, it's probably different within the home environment. You know, they know me as...
Were you nervous? What am I going to say? Were you like, oh, please, please?
I was a bit worried. A bit on edge. And you know what? It's their first time on camera as well. So, you know, there was a big moment for them, but they did really well.
They did.
Well, as Father of the Year, tell us what you think it is that a male figure, a strong role model in a kid's life can do.
Yeah, Lisa, well, you know, being Father's Day this week, I think the most important thing is to just shine a light on the importance of all father's figures, mentors, role models and sport coaches, you know, one of which I've been. And so I play many of those roles. But, you know, there's millions around the country. But I think many of them perhaps wouldn't realise the incredible impact that they do either directly or intentionally or inadvertently have on young people in their vicinity. And we often think just about our own biological children, but actually the research is really clear that male mentors and role models in young girls and boys' life are incredibly important for their self-image, for their physical and mental health, for their academic achievement, for all of those life outcome indicators. It's really, really important. But of course, there's a negative side to it as well. And, you know, we see child neglect and abuse and things around the country. And so there is an organisation this week that people who feel that they'd like some help, that they'd like to develop better tools to have more positive relationships with the children in their lives, that they can go to the fatheringproject.org. That's the organisation who basically are behind these awards. And really, ultimately, that's what it's about, is trying to shine a spotlight on that and say to people, go there, get the resources. They're in over 1,000 schools. They've helped over 450,000 fathers, and 750,000 kids have better relationships. So they really do a fabulous job.
Craig, you've had a life in the public eye for a really long time. A lot of Australians know and love you, but you've had this really incredible transformation, I guess, in recent years, becoming an advocate, you know, moving beyond everything that you had done before. And I'm sure there are times when at home it's a bit like, well, you just come back and, you know, help here. You must have had a lot of support from the family to be able to become this incredible voice for so many that you have been.
Well, we're fortunate because there's many different types of families, and, you know, and I'm incredibly fortunate. I have an extraordinary wife. Her name is Lara, and she's not in the public eye very much, but, you know, in our house we have a joke. We say that she really is Mother and Father of the Year, right? She's really incredible. But, you know, we all need those support networks around us to enable us to go out and do what it is that we want to do. I must say, though, you know, for both of us, our children are very much the centre of our life.
It's not your children. You've helped these young women evacuate from Afghanistan, and they call you their Aussie dad. So does that mean you enforce screen time and...
Not quite to that extent, but just we try and provide every support that they need now, but they're an incredible young group of kids. And I think, and I hope what that shows is the importance of also stepping across, all of us, across those religious and cultural barriers. You know, we talk about multiculturalism in Australia a lot, and we hold ourselves up and for, you know, in many respects rightly. But when we as adult, particularly adult males in this context, have an opportunity to relate to provide guidance, to support, to open doors for kids outside of our own family, but across those barriers, which, you know, it is so very, very powerful. And particularly for new arrivals and refugees and the communities that I work with, to have anyone supporting them and demonstrating to them that we do see you as equal, you are welcome here, and we're going to go out of our way to provide everything for you that we do so for our own children.
Do you have, Father of the Year, do you have a classic dad joke? Do you have one?
A dad joke.
Yeah, do you have one? Do you have one?
I don't have one off the top of my head. You give me some here that I can carry back.
Pull my finger. There you go. That's the old classic.
All right, Craig, congratulations and thanks for joining us.
Thanks.